Hi everyone, welcome back to High School Science 101. Today we are talking chemistry, and this is one of my most requested videos, the difference between elements, compounds, and mixtures. Let's get started. Everything around us is made up of atoms, and there are 118 different types of atoms that we call the elements. And you can represent all of the elements on a big table, which we call the periodic table of elements. Each element has its own set of characteristics, so it might be quite a small atom, it might be a large atom, it might be a metal or a non-metal, it might like to react easily with things, it might not like reacting with things. And so based on its position within the periodic table, we can actually determine a fair bit about that element. For example, all of the metals tend to be grouped together, and all the non-metals tend to be grouped together. Each element has its own preference for how it likes to bond with other atoms. For example, we have our seven noble gases, helium, argon, krypton, radon, xenon, organesson, and neon. And these guys like to hang out as just individual atoms. They don't like bonding with other atoms from other elements, or even other atoms from the same element. They like hanging out on their own, so we call them monatomic. Mono meaning one, monatomic meaning single atoms. Some elements prefer to hang out as a pair or as a cluster of the same type of atom, and we call these molecular elements because a molecule is when you have two or more atoms stuck together. So for example, hydrogen likes to hang out as a pair of hydrogen atoms, so we call that a molecular element. Nitrogen, oxygen, and chlorine also like to form pairs, so they are also molecular elements. Our third type of atomic arrangement applies to 80% of our elements, our metals, and that's this three-dimensional shape that we call a lattice. And they don't all form cubes like this, so they form other different three-dimensional shapes, but in all cases we call it a lattice. When you have two or more elements bonding together, we get what's called a compound, and these can be in the form of a molecule or a lattice. Water is an example of a molecular compound because it forms molecules, and each molecule of water contains two hydrogen atoms for every one oxygen atom. Carbon dioxide is another example of a molecular compound because it forms molecules that contain two oxygen atoms bonded to every one carbon atom. And this is how we get the names carbon dioxide and H2O. We can also have compound lattices. So salt, for example, is sodium chloride, and sand is silicon dioxide, and both of these compounds tend to form these 3D crystal lattice structures. Lastly, we have mixtures, and mixtures contain a whole bunch of different elements and compounds, and we don't necessarily know the proportions of the elements within a mixture, unlike in a compound, where we know exactly what the proportions of the elements are. And for this reason, we can't give a chemical formula for a mixture because we don't actually know the proportions of the elements. For example, if we had a bottle of pure distilled water, we can label it as H2O. In that bottle of water, there are two hydrogen atoms for every one atom of oxygen. We can't write a chemical formula for tap water though, because it's a mixture. It contains water molecules, but it also contains chlorine, fluoride, nitrates, phosphates, and a whole bunch of other elements that we might not even be aware of. So we can't actually label that H2O because it's a mixture of all different elements and compounds. And that's the end of today's lesson. We've covered elements, which are different types of atoms. We've covered compounds, which are made of two or more different elements bonded together. And mixtures contain a variety of compounds and elements. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.